Good morning, YouTubers. I hope you enjoyed your weekend. Today is Monday, August 15th, 2022. And yeah, my grandson's here. My granddaughter's here. Currently it's 58 degrees there at Yellowstone. Supposed to be a high of 83. USGS is reporting 4 earthquakes for the last 24 hours. There's been more, of course. The most recent was a magnitude 3.0. Using Google Earth, here's the location. USGS said it was a magnitude 2.3. And we'll bring it out so you can see the area. Let's see, we got Swan Lake up over here. And Canyon Village over here. That's where they had the sewage problem. This is the Madison River area. Hedgen Lake to the left. And that's the Sour Creek Resurgent Dome. And then down here would be the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome. That's where the live web camera is at. And then Yellowstone Lake. You can see at the bottom there, it comes in as a magnitude 3.09. It occurred at 6:06 a.m. local time. And we'll go with the seismic signature right there. This earthquake was tectonic in nature, but it did rattle up the magma chamber. It was in the upper part of the magma chamber. Here's a view of the magma chamber. And let's make this larger because where it was at was up over here. You can see over here on the right, it's got the depth in kilometers. And we'll bring it over so you can see. We got the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome, the Sour Creek Resurgent Dome, the Cap of Rhyolite, etc. Here's another image of the flow of the magma. But up over here would be the Sour Creek Resurgent Dome. Here we got the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome. You can see how the magma is flowing. And then up towards the Madison River area. Another image showing the depth of the magma. Now this is only 2 kilometers, the one on the left. Let me make that bigger and then I'll pull it over. So 2 kilometers is about 1.4 miles below sea level. And see the little dots here? Let me bring it in a little bit more. This here is the Mallard Lake Resurgent Dome. That is the Sour Creek Resurgent Dome. This is the Madison River area. There's actually pockets of melt where people are walking, only about 600 feet under the surface. So this 3.0 earthquake was only 3.8 miles below sea level. And it's cracking the rock, making the ground more brittle to make way for the lava to come through. It's actually called magma when it's still under the ground. But because it's got that rhyolite top, it would probably be an explosive eruption when it decides to finally erupt, when it builds up enough pressure for that to happen. Another image of the magma chamber, you can see we got the different dike intrusion that's coming up and the different pockets of melt. And we got in kilometers here. Yellowstone still is screaming every so often. Here you can see we got a blank spot within the magma that came up. Yeah, it builds up pressure and then it pops. And the magma rushes through, comes up so fast that the equipment can't record it. Now this was this morning, just a little while ago when I downloaded the data. This would have been at 8:43 a.m. today. And we'll go to the spectrogram, see where it's blank. 8:47 a.m. There's another one right there. Let's go to the spectrogram. Go back to the signature. 8:58 a.m. Just before 9 a.m. There's another one. Let's go there. Okay, over here. Let me bring it over a little bit. Oh, okay. 8:14 a.m. And then right afterwards, let's bring this over. We got a small popping of the ground. of the rock. Yeah, Utah, it says here, 1.64 just came in. So, yeah, it gushed through, created more pressure, more popping of the rock. And let's extract this. See, rounded tops. Magma. That is lava, or magma. Magma on the move, rising up. Magma naturally wants to rise. I'll make it a little bit bigger for you. All kinds of popping going on. Yeah, you can just click on different ones and see where the ground's getting brittler and brittler. Yeah, look at, oh, that's a screw wave. Yeah, that's a screw wave. I might be pronouncing it wrong, but it's called a torlino. Yeah, you see that when magma's coming up. Another term is harmonic tremors. They called them torlinos before they gave them the name of harmonic tremors. Looks like around 7 p.m. last night, we probably had 3, maybe 4 hours of increased activity. Let's bring this up. There's a whole bunch here at Soda Butte marked in red. Oop, I'm off the line. There you go. We'll just bring it over. All kinds of them. Can you see them there? And where's this one at? That's a little one there. Another one. Where is it? Right there? Yep. Can you see all that through there? At about 8:57 p.m., yeah, there's more. This is what's called blobs of magma that was coming into the system at that time. You can tell by the thickening of the lines. That's their actual scientific term, blobs of magma. And we'll go over here. Yeah, look at that. Harmonic tremors, yeah. And it lasted for probably close to an hour. Yeah, where it was coming into the system. Let me make that a little bit bigger for you. Yeah. Here's a capture of the west entrance coming into the park. Yeah, they're going to be packed today. And it looks like we got a meeting going on with geologists, possibly. We got a park ranger here. Yeah, I don't know what's going on down there. They all got their little notepads out. There's another ranger, it looks like. Yeah, they're going to be packed today. And it's Monday, so it's rather surprising how many people are coming in today. You know, not being a weekend. All right, 10:15. Which was real interesting. Here's Soda Butte, and you can see it was screaming at that time. Let me make that bigger. And there was an earthquake just before that. So the ground popped, allowed some magma to come into the system. Right there, let's go to the spectrogram. Go back to the signature. This earthquake is not being reported. Magnitude 1.64. That would have been about 5:15 a.m. today. This here is Maple Creek's monitor. This here is the borehole for the Madison River area. And it shows the same earthquake. About 7:48 universal time. That would have been at 2:48 local time. You can see we got another earthquake. It's on all three monitors. Soda Butte, the borehole for the Madison River area, and then Maple Creek. That one comes in as a magnitude 1.75. And we'll go to the seismic signature. 1.75. 2:44. Now, they did report an earthquake at that time. We got the borehole in the center for the Madison River, Maple Creek on the right, and Soda Butte. Let me show you Soda Butte prior. 2:42. 2 minutes before this earthquake. Yeah, more screaming of the volcano when the rock popped, and it brought up magma, and it was so loud it couldn't record once again. So let's make this smaller, and we'll go back to the three different monitors. See, 2 minutes later, that's when the magma came in. It popped, gushing in. This comes in as a magnitude 1.90. Let me pull it down a little bit farther. 1.90. And there's its seismic signature. Even though the seismic signature really extended, the magma kept coming in. See that? If I shorten the seismic signature, comes in as a magnitude 1.57. So we'll call it that, a 1.57. Also for the Madison River area, but USGS said it was a 0.7. Yeah, they took off the 1. So, 1.57, I'll call it, but they said it was a 0.7. 208, another earthquake that's not being reported. Now that's universal. 9:08 p.m. last night. And once again, we got the popping of the rock here at Soda Butte, where it screamed. Let me make that bigger. Came in, 208, 55 seconds, almost, 209, right there. Let's extract that. Rounded tops. Right there. Let's make this, we'll go down. The borehole, it looks like possibly the largest signature. I don't know. Okay, we got the borehole, and then we got Maple Creek. That's a little one here at Maple Creek, 0.67. We'll go to the spectrogram. That's Maple Creek. And the borehole for the Madison River, it also comes in. Let me bring it down as a 0.67. And there's its seismic signature right there. This is what the borehole was showing when I pulled the files. Yeah, see, we got harmonic tremors at the borehole. Let me pull it up so you can see it. Borehole 207. Like I said, I think they got a, hopefully it's going to be a small eruption coming. Yeah, I certainly hope that's the case. Look at that. And we'll just pull it over, continue pulling it over. Yeah, and then over here also, and this is what it was showing when I, let me grab that. Yeah, it's currently at 10:26 a.m. This is the swarm or stream view. The bottom one here is Soda Butte. I don't have this earthquake on there. This one here is Maple Creek, and this one here at the top is the borehole for the Madison River area. Yeah, interesting. Now it's screaming when the rocks pop. So there must be a lot of pressure down there pushing this magma up, and that's why I feel that there's going to be an eruption. Who knows when? They got that rhyolite top holding all the gas is in. But it's still showing the same activity, and it has never done this in all the years that I've been watching what's going on at Yellowstone. Never done this before. This is all new. See, here's Little West Thumb that it was showing. I didn't download its files because I know that it's screaming there. This is where they got that crack at the bottom of the lake, and you can see between that same time frame of 8 o'clock last night and onward for what, 1, 2, 3 hours. Yeah, it was also doing its screaming. And there's Grant Village. That's an interesting signature right there. I bet you it was screaming. Horse Butte. Now I'm wondering if the magma, the current flow of magma isn't coming in from the Snake River Plateau because Horse Butte's closer to that area. And you can see here that it was showing the signs of the magma coming in before, all the way over there at Little West Thumb. Yeah. Yep, it's really active today, but, yeah. Anyways, we'll keep an eye on this. This is looking at the upper geyser basin, looking down into the valley there. Yeah, look at that. Anyways, if you have any thoughts or comments or questions, put them down below. Keep prepping. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.